So dear friends, we are into the second part of our educative posting video. We'll take up broadly what this term the council's members are contesting about. Each of the persons will take up their strengths and weakness, but in relation to what they are supposed to achieve. The burning issues, dear friends, is if the institute works as a professional body, automatically the respect will be enhanced. You can see, we'll take the example of the Supreme Court, Honorable Supreme Court of India. After the takeover of Honorable Chief Justice N.V. Ramana, and before that, the people have lost confidence, hope on this judiciary, which is the savior of democracy and the fundamental rights. So the institution is already there, a great institution, and because of some people, things may not be as it should be. So the system is different, individuals are different. If you take our CA Institute, over this period, the revenues have grown enormously. Any revenues have grown enormously, because of which the council members, the presidents, they are spending millions of rupees to win the elections. Why should they win, spend so much, come to the election? This is not a salaried job. They may tell 100 things. Of course, everyone will have something to contribute for the profession. Name is there. But that is apart. The power and the fruits of power are driving forces. This is unquestionably the fact. Now, if you take, for example, when the Honorable Madras High Court passed strictures against the CA Institute for financial indiscipline and not following the regulations, transparent process, Institute did not bother. Even in case of ICAA, Honorable Madras High Court asked the question, what is this ICA? Whose the name, the trademark belongs to ICAI. It's a separate institution with a common seal. A member cannot claim a right in that. That's why it was dismissed. But why are they keeping quiet? Such a blatant misuse of the trademarks by another institution. ICAI Institute did not bother to listen to Madras High Court. Nowhere. And when the when they realized, ICAI Central Council presidents and all, that if you see the 323 council meeting, Mr. Jaydeep Narendra Shah told them, and the secretary of that time, one gentleman was there, he was a storekeeper, he rose to that president, I forgot his name, but they told them, if you act funny, the council was asking so many questions to them, why you have done like this, why you didn't do this, it's a clear cut case of fraud, that's clear. But when all the council members started asking, that person told them, if you act funny, I will also open up the Pandora box. That's all, everybody kept quiet. Because every council member is a nominee or relative or disciple of the past presidents who have their own club. If you want to become vice president by election, you need their blessings. So it is all between one them. So that is why they are not interested to, they are telling everybody you should have independent audit. But they are not interested to have independent audit. Here is a system where the president appoints the auditor who is regulated by ICA. Is there any independence? He gives reports to the president, the council will accept on their. What a strange situation. Then what happened? In that next president, immediately after this order passed by this, the president came. What he did, you know, he didn't take any action against Jaydeep Narendra Shah or anybody. He passed one resolution for which all the council members are party, that no affairs, no minutes of the meeting should be circulated to the members. One resolution was passed, which is ultra virus. So that means they are very careful to protect their misdeeds. And all other council members, they thought, okay, why should I oppose it? I may get a chance to become vice president. I will also do like this. So they have kept quiet. Very simple. Why do you have so many committees? If you see, any council member is a member of 20 committees. Can you do justice for that? And then that committees add to administrative costs. Nobody will listen. Employees are the bosses there in the institute. And nobody will listen to you. Nobody will take the phone calls. They will be very abusive. They will be very abusive. You would go to that disciplinary committee or the legal department and all. They think they are the bosses. That is the problem. You understand? So it is not a situation we can solve overnight. Let us have an auditor by controller and auditor general. If these council members come to you for elections, voting, please ask them, what is your view on this? That is the problem. Millions of rupees, foreign travel, everything is spent happily. You understand? You can canvas for the audits. Now contracts are there, huge crores of rupees, non-transparent contracts where which commissions are taken. And then excellent centers. And then disciplinary jurisdiction, against that also money is exchanged. That is why that NEFRA has come in and doing good work. So you should ask them, what is your opinion? And today the central council member has no liberty to bring this, what is happening in the council meeting minutes. Forget about the transparency with regard to this video conferencing where Rajya Sabha is there. If we do all this only, the respect for the nation, the public will go up in on us. But these people are not willing to do. The disciplinary jurisdiction is misused. No central council member, no president, past president will be under fire. They will be protected by spending the members' money. That's all. Why do you need so many staff? The lakhs of rupees salaries being paid. Are you utilizing them? If you take our board of studies, with due respect to all, one madam was in the disciplinary jurisdiction. Council members have complained about her conduct. She was removed from there. Where did they put her? In the education board of studies director or chairman. What is this? Such a big work is being done like this. And the post qualification services, you see, you get no knowledge and nothing is valuable, but you are trying to do something. So therefore, friends, my request for you is choose at least 5 or 6 good people who can raise the issues, unmindful of whether they'll win next time or not, unmindful of their positions as directors of various government companies later. Those people must be given priority. Now, do we have the council members who are contesting in this? First and foremost step from south, Sri Priya madam, young lady, and very, I'm talking from the angle of a council member. She was in the central council first term, then second term she didn't contest, now she is contesting. As a person, she is a humble, obedient, I can say a lady. She is young, very young. So we can say girl because I know her from education side. But she has good, noble motive is what I have, in my opinion. You may question based on my experience. During that period, she tried her best to promote the resolution, insolvency and bankruptcy court she did. She is extraordinarily brilliant person. Memory is amazing. And she tried her best to educate the members. So, as a humble lady, she will now, I am sure that she will try her best to contribute to the members' professional opportunities and then the knowledge quotient. I think she can do that. Service-minded lady. Most importantly, during this COVID time, she volunteered to help this Tamil Nadu government locating beds for the needy, oxygen. It was a terrible time because of the mismanagement of the central government. And she was acknowledged for her services. So she means business, understand. She is not giving slogans. And she will, you can't change her, no? She may grow, let her become director of companies, let her become a chairperson of Reserve Bank of India. She is knowledgeable. That is not an issue. You have to grow. We are not finding fault with those people getting positions. But during this tenure, you don't do for aspiring to that position. That's all. Therefore, I prefer you also must check up. These are all the factual position. Being a lady, she may not be very bold to be against these council members who are north-based, predominantly patriarchal minds, highly dominant natured persons, unless she is supported. Now, another madam, Archana, and then Kanta Sharma. Now, we will take up Kanta Sharma ji. Kanta Sharma ji is equally intelligent like Sri Priya, madam, and she is very vocal. She is a bold lady. That I know her for 6 long years, and she will do. She will get positions because of her talent. Let her get, but she will make CA proud. And during the council, she will ask questions. She is sure to ask questions based on her past. She can question people. Sri Priya madam may not be able to do that. But in a combination of this, they will raise the issues. She is, Sri Priya being in South and all, she is mild, soft and docile. But this madam is like Indira Gandhi. And she is going to win, there is no problem. But all these candidates are going to win, there is no issue on that. But it is worth helping them to find your cause. That is, you should have mind to correct. If injustice is done, these people will be able to question. Therefore, we have to encourage them. Ladies first, second knowledgeable, courageous. And she did so much. The earlier presidents did a lot of mistakes. She took up that matter. She went on writing. Her articles you please read. And nobody will keep writing all this unnecessarily. I know her personally. Very humble, polite, but aggressive madam. And it is a precious. They are contesting. We should be happy. 2, 3. Archana. Archana is more stronger than when it comes to fighting. She will think nothing less. And she has to win. I think she is contesting from Mumbai, western region. But she will replay, she will be equal to 20 central council members who are aspiring for jobs. Understand? And we all will back them. Then we will get a dramatic change. Whatever we want automatically will come. Dear friends, you must realize the most difficult problems have simple solutions. Remember, in Tamil Nadu, the advocates used to go on strike every time for just like that. Honorable Chief Justice R.K. Agarwal ji said, judges are afraid to come to Tamil Nadu because of this. Now when Sanjay Kishan Kaul, Honorable Chief Justice, came. Now he is in Supreme Court. When the same lawyers were doing something, he asked them to put in jail and then disciplinary cases initiated. That's all strikes gone. Understand, nobody had courage. He is a remarkable personality. That way, the Tamil Nadu judiciary set right. Of course, he was assisted by my friend, Honorable Ram Subramaniam Jay, my classmate, and Times of India, Mr. Subramani. All of them took up and they did it, and it's good for the lawyers now. Therefore, CA is easy. It's very easy if only you allow these three plus few others. I am not aware of any other counsel. I can only talk about my southern India, South India persons. So, now the things are very clear. You have South Sri Priya Madam, and Central is North or Central Kanta Sharmaji, and Western region is Archana. They are really good. They will do the job. I don't know about others, because of which I am not able to commit. Now comes the next issue. The president. Who is going to be our president? Mr. Debashis. He is a nice man. PhD, he is a doctorate. Very knowledgeable, very knowledgeable, highly educated from West Bengal. So they would be more pro, not be like doing all this galana. At least he will be a nice president, a persuasive president, would like to convince the government. That is very important for us, because the tough government is there who dislikes CA Institute. They, for a minute, they want to attack CA Institute. So this, today the need is persuasive team who can convince the government that CA Institute is not anybody's property, but the property of the nation. They are the temples which build modern India. It's not just like that CA Institute means belongs to ex-president or vice-president. No. This government must be made to understand one of the greatest institutions you are trying to kill. These are the temples. You know that we had a greatest Nalanda University was there. What did Muslims do? The invaders, not Muslims. That Mughalai or some fellows, they destroyed that. Now what you are doing, you are destroying CA Institute. Yes, more than Nalanda. Such is the problem. So now today, whether like or not, we have to accept this is the problem with the government and try to convince the government. It may be possible the who takes decision is the Prime Minister. He must be convinced. Somebody should be able to talk. We had Piyush Goyal, who is a CA, but he doesn't help the CA Institute. So therefore, there is a difficult term, this is the next, where this electing these three people will be very good. Then comes, I am talking about South now, Prasanna. Prasanna is a sincere person. He tries the best, and we should protect him and come back. So with a rejuvenated confidence, he will come. Now, there is a gap between Dayanivas Sharmaji, and Dayanivas is very good, very knowledgeable person. But then he is a president man. Whatever president say, he will say yes. Secondly, he is a Hindi speaking person. I am not against Hindi, because he may not object to the presidents who try to enforce Hindi. Because the government wants to push Hindi against everybody. Therefore, it will be, one has to think whether he will be able to protect the interest of the South Indians. So, then you have Muppala Sridhar. He is also, I don't know much about him, but everybody is telling he is very good. And he has got a very good chance to get in. And Prasanna, and one of these two. Entire Andhra region is over. And coming to Tamil Nadu, we have Rajendra Kumar. Since Mr. Vijay Kumar ji is not there in the game, Rajendra Kumar has got very good chance. And but again, he is also, when in the first term, he was only siding Jaideep Narendra Shah. Absolutely. And even during this period, whenever I call him, when it comes to this CA, ICAA, NEFRA issue, he will not talk. And so therefore, even as a chairman, he was only playing the game of Manoharan. And so therefore, he would like to use all of these people as what is called as a leader to become president. So it is for you to make your decision on this. He will not take bold decisions, 100%. He will never confront the president or anything. If you compare Archana Madam or Kanta Sharma as models, if they are 100, this man will be 1%, not even 1%. Both Dayanibha Sharma and this. But Prasanna will definitely advisory. Understand, he will ask. There is no questions. Now comes the Karnataka. Karnataka, one man has to win. In between Madhav Murthy ji and Kota Srinivas. Madhav Murthy ji is trying his luck for several times and is not able to win. And Madhav Murthy ji, when he is also exactly like Rajendra Kumar. He'll have to catch somebody. Nityananda was there. He was catching him. Some of these things. Nice man. He's a good person. And whether he will really raise questions against the council, get something done, I feel it is a past based on the past, he may not. But Kota Srinivas is there. He is a young fellow. He may not be, I think, 40 years also. And if he takes a job, he will go through it. Fund was there. He wanted to get money. He didn't leave anybody. And so Srinivas is young, whereas Madhav Murthy is not good health. I got it. I'm not canvassing for them, but one of them will win. And Srinivas is young. He can represent the interests of the Karnataka very strongly. Bold fellow. He doesn't care. We had Madhukar Iragange. He was also a tough fellow who used to raise questions, question the presidents and all. He's a highly intellectual person. He did that. But this gentleman will ask questions, will support the cause of the members, is my sincere opinion. And he's an independent person. And what is there? He, as a chairman also, he was a very independent chairman of Bangalore branch, chairman of SIRC. He has got the experience also with him. And Madhav Murthy was, I don't know whether he has become chairman of this SIRC, I don't remember. But between these two choices before you, whether you choose young, independent thinking, ready to work hard and represent the interest of Karnataka boldly, or you want to choose a mild, soft, attaching to the power, not of as good health as Kota Srinivas has. That is. Then comes the Kerala. Kerala, Jomon. Jomon is intellectually very good. He is my student. And but again, Jomon is a disciple of Babu. Babu Abraham is a media, via media, but he is always with power. And he did work as a chairman of board of studies. Babu has contributed a lot to the profession in his own way. Instead of taking guns against the president or the system, he is a person going with the system. And this man, Jomon, will listen to Babu. So there is a guidance to Babu, a guidance to Jomon. Jomon is very intelligent, accounting standards and all that. How far they will, if suppose some majority are strong, then these people will join and raise this. After all, anything injustice, what's wrong? So therefore, intellectually, Jomon is good, young man, and he is guided by Babu Abraham and he representing Kerala. Kerala needs one person to represent their grievance. Karnataka needs one person to represent their grievance. And Andhra and Telangana together, two persons. But because MP Vijay Kumar is not in the game, the students' votes will go to the respective personalities. And Chennai, Tamil Nadu, we have Abhishek Bachchan, Abhishek Murali. Highly intellectual person, he is the son of Mr. Murali, a nice boy, very pleasant personality. But then, in the first term, it is because of the force of his father Murali, he came in. He never participated in any programs, anything. And his father, seeing that he doesn't get, he joined ICWN. Power. Power is the driving force. I remember Murali once telling me that council membership is like a tiger tasting blood. It cannot leave it. And so he jumped to ICWA and tried to promote the ICWA against CA Institute. Now, what is the use of his education and all for us? He's, I think, has 1 mile education qualifications. And two, he is governed by his father. And they would like to be ICWA president, CA president. Like that they want to do. And definitely, it is of, as on today if you see, he never participated actively in the institute affairs. Everybody who asked the council members will tell. So then what is he going to do with his qualifications? He sent us a massive pamphlet full of his qualifications. We don't want a council member, does he need so much qualifications? And all these things are there, gaps. Every chance ICWAs are trying to intrude into CA domain. And CAs are very hard studied, you know, it's a very difficult course. And ICWA, with due respect to them, I'm telling you, IIMs are different from others. We have to be class apart. So therefore, it is choice is yours. I'm not saying you select this person, not select this person. I am nobody. I want everybody to win. I want everybody to win. If there is a, but then we need to protect our South Indian members' interest. Somebody who is dedicated, who will provide us good opportunities. Understand? And not go on with the president. This Devishishji is a good man. He is not from that, so West Bengal. So this year is good. And the next vice president, we don't know. Whether he is a fanatical in nature like Jambu Niharia. Jambusaria Niharia. He is a good man also. But then he is without emotionally connected to the language, he would not have made a statement. Or the government would have been pressurizing the ICA to go for it. That is the reason. So we need to protect it. So we need the CAG audit. And we need, we don't need so many committees. We need a transparent system. Central Council must have elections. I mean, the AGM should be there. People should raise the issues. The institute affairs have to be published. Video conferencing meetings. The system should be transparent. What is the problem for you? Why are you closing it down? Let the disciplinary jurisdiction be removed from institute and go to NEFRA. And let NEFRA does not have the past presidents. Because as a, you see, president has power to appoint any person to committees. Now, Mr. Atul Gupta appointed whom? Himself in IFAC. Is it a transparent methodology? So therefore, I wish you all, go ahead and try your best, friends.